now we only have to watch people put in 4 tags instead of 8. I have literally never seen Waddle play Bowser Jr. I don't play with him that much. I play friendlies with him occasionally. I've seen him play a lot of DDD. I've seen him play a lot of, well, he's a Fox main. But never seen the Bowser Jr. But bet it's legit. All right, Ludwig. Ludwig's a solid pick. Ludwig is, like, pretty much always a solid pick, I think. It's the safe pick. Like, I don't know anybody that doesn't like Ludwig.
I don't.
How's it going?
What's going on? Who's playing? What's going on?
All right, so we've got Maloney leading off for the Charizard crew and Waddle opening up for the Bowser Jr. crew. Already we've got Waddle with a huge lead. Oh my gosh. Never seen this man play Bowser Jr., but I'm already impressed.
I've been seeing way too much Bowser Jr. recently. All the guys I brought in today to play in this tournament, every single one of them is going up against some kind of Bowser Jr. They showed up in force today.
Yeah, we've got we've got the Bows, Jaeger Bomb. Well, pretty much everyone on this crew except Waddle, I think, is a Bowser Jr. main.
Mm-hmm.
Waddle's Bowser Jr. No slouch, obviously, though, as he's really putting in some work. That was very impressive,
yeah.
That's just the matchup with some characters. Like, Charizard, I don't know, Flamethrower is so good.
Flamethrower, Fire Breath are really good for ledge options.
Yeah.
Multi-hits, really, just in general, are pretty amazing, especially ones that cover such a low ground.
Yeah, you can send Flamethrower, like, pretty much straight down if you want to, which is really nice for Charizard.
That's a good finish there by Waddle.
Yeah. Generally, you don't want to, like, neutral get up against Bowser Jr. just because that forward smash. There's not really, like, an opportunity where, like, a lot of multi-hits, you can, like, do a neutral get up and, like, shield in between hits. You can't really do that with Bowser Jr.'s up smash.
Mm-hmm.
It's really hard. So it'll usually just smack you. Also, the his up B will catch you too. Oh, wow!
Ooh, that killed, forward smash tilted downward. Nicely done.
That killed Charizard.
Mm-hmm. I was about to say that whole stock, Waddle was just in charge. He had a really nice neutral game there.
Oh yeah.
Wow! Look at those strings.
Yeah, I like Waddle's really taking advantage of Charizard's lack of landing options, and Bowser Jr.'s like quick normals in the air with, you know, fairly good range,
mm-hmm.
especially up air.
I'm hoping to see a little bit more of the Rock Smash because it does kind of like go through a lot of stuff that Waddle can use.
Oh yeah, very true.
But again, Waddle's been doing really good spacing out his opponent, just like throwing his moves out at just the right time, and right as I'm saying that, he misses it. decides to take a back air. 2016,
yeah.
Super Smash Brothers. Nice back air.
Charizard's back air is terrifying.
Oh, almost
dude.
Goes for the hammer attack. At least he's heavy enough to survive a little bit longer.
Yeah, oh yeah, and like, Zard kills at absurd percent sometimes. Like, he has some crazy moves, dude. His up B, he can just super armor through whatever he wants and take you out at such a low percent.
Oh, there's the hammer to take it out.
Yeah, that was a really nice bait. He went low. Maloney thought he was covering, like he was safe, because Waddle made it look like he was covering the low recovery. Went with the up B, caught him recovering high.
And that hammer has like way bigger hitbox than even I can realize. It's
yeah.
It's surprising how quick it comes out, how much of a hitbox it covers. Is this the first kill here?
This would be the second. This is the re-grab, I think.
Mm-hmm. And I was saying, this whole first stock, like, look how dominating Waddle is here. Yeah, there's that forward smash.
It wasn't even a re-grab. He just...
It was the forward smash there that killed him.
Yeah, his invincibility ran out.
Yep.
Probably because of how long he was in the air. I know airtime affects ledge invincibility.
Mm-hmm. Who do we got up now? Oh, Adorable Knight. There we go. Almost got that balloon in the beginning. All right, and here we go. One, and we begin. Where's our Adorable Knight from? He's from Michigan?
West Michigan, yes.
Yep.
He's like really good, actually. He's a Luigi player, and he does like really well whenever he comes over to East Michigan for these monthlies.
It's hard to not identify Luigi mains, to be honest with you. There aren't a whole lot of them out there, and every single one of them that play, they're just... Everyone has a story to tell with the Luigi main. Everyone does. Do you remember that one time where Luigi did the Luigi thing? Yeah. Yeah, I remember the Luigi thing. Let's all not talk about it anymore.
All my stories are before the Cyclone patch, though. Once that happened, all my problems went away.
Wow, Waddle has really shown that he knows this matchup. He is completely dominating in the ground game.
Yeah.
Which is surprising. Against a Charizard, you don't normally control the ground game.
Yeah, but he's just, like, he's spacing so well. He's picking, like, all the right opportunities to go in. Oh, my gosh. The double jab up B, though. Yeah, Charizard's jab is an incredible boxing option. It's so fast. Gets your opponent out of your face.
Oh, ooh, don't roll away
yeah,
from that.
Yeah, that was definitely, like, a panic roll. It was like, my shield got hit. I'm going to roll without really, like... Well, it was just out of habit, I'm sure.
Absolutely. Oh, are we going to finish this off? Are we going to finish this off? Oh, almost had the read there.
Oh.
Bowser Jr. typically has... Have you seen the hitbox sizes on his forward air?
No, I haven't, but it's disjointed. I've played against him enough to know that it's, like, way bigger than it appears.
I've actually doing a lot of research on Bowser Jr. recently. It's just, it's surprising. Oh. Everything he does is surprising. He's just full of mix-ups and just, maybe that's how he wins tournaments, is people just don't know how to play against him. You don't understand his hitboxes. He's kind of like playing against Bayonetta, where you have to do research on the character before you play against her.
Yeah, absolutely. He's just a bag of tricks.
You're going to have a hard time outspacing Junior if you don't know any of his hitboxes.
Yeah, he really rewards, like, creative play.
There's that
play.
Up throw finisher. There we go. 163%, I guess.
Yeah, but Waddle did get that one stock extra credit, so... You know, he definitely played his part, especially considering that I'm pretty sure he's the only non-Bowser Jr. main on the team.
Mm-hmm.
So that's already a very good sign.
Yeah, he brought
for
him
this
back.
Crew. Yeah.
We're at what, 9-7 now? 9-8?
9-8,
like
I believe.
He brought it back for him.
Absolutely. So we got the Bow sitting down next.
I was a little disappointed I missed the Bowser crew battle. It's unfortunate.
Right. Yeah, I was like, I'm a Zero Suit main, and none of our good
Zero
Suits
are here.
Why
are we sitting next to each
me.
Other? I'm confused. We don't get along.
Hey, I'm fine with fighting Bowser, man.
I know you are. I'm out.
No, none of the good Zero Suits were here, so I was trying to, like, fiend to, like, get on, like, the Lucina crew or something.
Nice.
But didn't work out.
All right, here we go.
Getting into the next game, though, here.
Starting just like Diddy Kong.
Yep.
Getting that projectile out. Got to have as many hitboxes as possible if you want to survive.
Yeah, and the Mecha Koopa is, like, it's a very nice way to approach. It's really, like, Bowser Jr.'s saving grace in a lot of matchups where, like, if he has to approach, he's probably going to need that Mecha Koopa. Because there are, like, so many creative things you can do with it. Side B is a bit limited just because, like, any character with a disjoint can kind of stop it on reaction.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, being able to threaten the Mecha Koopa along with the side B is, like, really, really good.
At the same time, it could be a double-edged sword. Like, there's a lot of, for example, the hitbox on the Mecha Koopa doesn't even come out until after it's done rolling. So if you're a fast enough character, you can go and pick it up real quick, or you can just straight up run past it and punish him if he uses it on the ground.
Oh my gosh.
2016.
That was beautiful.
Nice
spacing.
Back air. But also, and then, you know, there's a lot of different ways for you to pick it up as well.
Oh yeah.
And you don't want to get hit by that explosion. Doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but it does have a lot of knockback.
Yeah, and it like... You lose stage control for getting hit by it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, that alone is, like, super important.
Man, does Bowser Jr. even have the A button? Oh, that's right. He's got a forward smash and a down air.
Ooh. Oh, really? That was funny. I didn't know the side B would just bounce off Mecha Koopa like that.
I think he hit the side of the stage, actually. I believe he hit the ledge.
Maybe. Yeah.
Oh, no, never mind. Koopa's gone. 160% back throw or something like that.
Yeah, even
does
even
Bowser Jr. even have a like an actual kill throw? Like a decent one?
Back throw at the ledge, that's pretty much it.
At 160%?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's Charizard. It probably would have killed like other characters earlier.
I got you.
So it's kind of situational, but not something to count out. It's not like it's something you'll never see. Mm-hmm.
Is Kiba in this crew battle?
Who?
Kiba, he's from Ohio. He's a Bowser Jr. main.
Oh,
there's
the
hammer combos.
I don't think so. I don't remember who the fourth member is, actually.
I'm sorry I missed the early stages of this fight. I really wanted to see who was all involved.
No, you came in at the very beginning, actually.
Oh, how many people are in each crew battle?
Four? Crew.
Oh, okay, yeah. Four. That makes more sense. Man, it's not just Waddle that knows the matchup. Apparently, the Bowser. Maybe this is just a bad character matchup against Charizard.
Yeah.
I can see it, though. Like, Charizard doesn't really have a whole lot of options against projectiles. He's a heavy character, so he can kind of be bounced around a lot. He doesn't have the greatest maneuverability. So getting around all of those projectiles is probably a problem. I like to think that Bowser Jr. is a really, really bad matchup for say, Bowser. So I suppose it could be said the same for Charizard.
That should be it. No.
Ooh, missed it, but then got the forward smash.
Yeah. That's like I was saying, you don't really want to like neutral get up against Bowser Jr. because he has two different very threatening kill moves that just cover the ledge.
Lots
so
of multi-hit. Yep, lots of multi-hits. Strong multi-hits even. Mm-hmm. Good times. Oh, hey, by the way, I'm the Riddler.
How's it going? I'm Iceman.
Iceman, I know. I didn't get to introduce myself. What's going on, guys? We're at Breakout. One of the better venues, one of the best venues, actually, that I've been to in Michigan.
Schoolcraft is so good. There's so much room here.
Mm-hmm.
It's so nice.
We love coming out here. We were actually joking about that. Colonies was saying, yeah, the only people I see wandering this college is Smashers. It's the only thing that they do here.
I'm stuck here, like, all week, man.
All right, so we got Linus. There we go. We're probably going to see a little bit more patience out of Linus. And more rock smashes. Nice.
Yeah,
there you go.
That was,
good pivot grab too. Nice conversion there out of the shield.
Yeah. Now I believe Linus is actually a Zard main, so Maloney and Adorable Knight obviously like have pretty impressive Charizards, but Linus actually like actively practices this character, so he'll probably know a little bit more about the matchup.
Right.
I think it's really important to know a matchup.
Ooh,
in.
Tried to grab that Koopa and failed.
Oh yeah. I think it's really important to know a matchup in a situation like this just because you are going to be playing the same matchup over and over and over.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you know Bowser Jr. Charizard, you're only fighting Charizards right now.
Right.
So, you know, that matchup knowledge is going to take you a long, long way.
Yeah, you've only got to know one character. And there it is. Like, we can see that Mecha Koopa, even though it's a double-edged sword, it's really, really worth the risk.
Oh, yeah.
If someone misses and gets hit by that thing, do you see the conversions he had on that? He was racking up a good 30-40% combos.
Yeah, it's really like one of Bowser Jr.'s like most potent tools.
That was a really good ledge coverage, by the way, by Linus. We would not let him get back on stage.
I like that Linus opted for the back throw forward air there instead of the down throw forward air, just because it got the Bowser off stage.
Ooh, there you go. Releasing the shield so we can get that power shield in. Nicely done. You don't want to get caught by that down air. It does not have a lot of... it's not lagless ending, but it's definitely quick.
Yeah, it's very threatening. Something that a lot of Bowser Juniors like to do is... since people see the side B coming and Bowser Jr. can't really do anything to, like, straight up beat shield out of it, they'll like to, like, jump right in front of your shield out of side B and then down air it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you unshield, that's so much damage.
Ooh, one too many side Bs there. About to say, I hope he realizes he's lost his jump.
Yeah, Linus, like, making just huge advantage of
Silly Junior, don't you know? If you played against Fire Mario, you should know. You're weak against Fire right now. Nope. All right, then. Good catch. Yeah, that's definitely a huge difference between the other Charizards we've seen, is that his ledge game is impeccable compared to the other two. He understands punishes, and with a heavy character, you need to know your punishes. Because normally, the heavier characters in this game, that's kind of how they're designed, right? They have themselves a really poor neutral game, or at least a mid to low, but their punishing game and their grab game is awesome.
Yeah.
And when you're playing against a projectile character, you need punishes. You need to be able to be patient and wait it out.
Oh, yeah. It's so crucial to, like, optimize everything and make the most of every opportunity you get, because you only get so many.
I would like to see Linus play a little bit more careful, like, use his fire breath a little bit more, but his forward air especially. His forward air is really good for spacing out his opponent and finishing it off with a back air. Charizard has a really surprising back air.
Oh, yeah. It kills, like, I'm pretty
sure
it's, like,
rolled into it again.
In the game.
Can't do that. You cannot roll into that cart.
Linus, like,
oh, missed the grab twice.
Somehow finding his way out of that minefield.
Three missed grabs there, causes himself at least 40% extra damage.
Yeah.
So get that Mecha Koopa out of here.
And the Bows might just make a clean sweep.
Oh, yep. Okay, chose to once again back off. That was the choice. And there it is.
Yeah, that up throw is going to
do it.
So now we are going to see Lonnie sitting down, see if he can take out Linus's final stock.
Oh, and there's most of the venue right there.
Oh, yeah. I love this area. See, like, at the actual...
It's big, like, enough that we're capable of having up to, what, 40 setups, I think, set up. And then we've also got
probably
5 to 6 friendlies right now.
Just yeah.
Friendly setups specifically for friendly. Ah, I love seeing venues with areas specifically for friendlies. It's good.
It's so nice. This area right here, actually, like, so the Vista Tech Center is basically, like, the recreational area for students. There aren't really, I mean, there are a couple classes held upstairs. And, like, the culinary arts students, like, work the kitchen, but this whole basement is, like, this is all for, like, extracurricular stuff. So this whole area is meant for watching movies. That's why we've got the TV that we can show the screen on. That's
right.
Why we've got, like, all these comfortable chairs. So it works out so nicely for, like, when people want to view the stream, because it's such a comfortable area.
Don't forget, right behind you is actually the projection screen.
Oh, yeah. There's a projector right here. So it's just, it's so convenient, man.
How did I miss that with the giant projector that's right in front of us?
What are you talking about? We're sitting against a white void.
Yeah. We're in the void.
Let's go, void.
Lonnie, I was actually, before the bracket was shifted, I was supposed to be playing against this guy round one.
Yeah,
and so most of last night was spent watching this guy's videos.
He's pretty good. Pretty good at Smash, even better at Pokemon.
Really?
Yeah, I think he won Yomicon VGC last year.
Yeah, that's right, he did.
I commentated that. It was like a 2-hour set. Me and Chibo that was the grind, dude. Like,
I remember looking up his YouTube videos, and I think his first two were the Pokemon Championships.
Yeah.
That is true. Now, a quick question, because I'm a bad commentator, I don't know this information. If you hold onto Mecha Koopa, does it explode at some point, or does the timer just hold still?
I think it does explode on you, but I'm not 100% sure.
That'd be good to know.
Yeah.
Let us know what's what.
I would imagine it explodes on you. Yeah, we'll see if Lonnie's Pokemon skills transfer. There are a lot of Charizards and competitive Pokemon. So we'll see if he the matchup knowledge transfers over.
I feel like if you were able to hold on to that Mecha Koopa, you should. It'd be like a lot like grabbing the gyro from Rob.
Oh, yeah.
You know, take that option away from him, especially if you have no projectiles of your own.
Yeah, it's possible. But then again, like, if you grab, like, Link or Toon Link's bombs, they'll blow up in your hand eventually, so.
Looks like chat's telling me that it does explode.
Yeah,
which makes sense. I mean, it does have a timer on it, unlike the gyro. So I can only assume it would do that. Now, this match is actually way, way more even than a couple of the other games we were watching. Both at over 100%. There's no real major victor here.
Yeah, although, this first stock does that. This first stock does mean a lot because like if Lonnie can seal this, okay. Yeah, I was going to say if Lonnie could seal that out by himself, that meant it was basically like 6 stocks to 3.
Basically.
This alone makes it a lot more doable for the Bowser crew. I think they have Shadow in the back. Shadow's probably their trump card.
Oh, they decided to save their trump card. They didn't go for a switch or a switch hitter.
Yeah, Linus is like very, very proficient at Zard though, but Shadow's at least equally skilled. Like he's been playing Zard since the game's been out.
Right.
You know, before all the buffs. Like he's just a Zard loyalist through and through. And that that spin out will take it. The cart spin out actually is a kill move.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a nice mix up sometimes.
You can kind of see right at the end there, like that's kind of how I expected this matchup to play out. Like right when he was at 150%, he started to play way more careful.
Oh yeah.
He started to just like really back off, try to get some forward airs in, his neutral airs in to keep all those projectiles out of there. I expected that almost the entire way through. It didn't happen until late in the game, but that's kind of what I expected of this matchup. And he survived way longer than any other stock by just doing that.
Yeah, and taking that one stock was a pretty big deal just because it makes it very doable for Shadow now. He can, like, you know, he could potentially drop one stock to Lonnie and take him, and then he could take out Jaeger Bomb 2 stocks to 3 instead of having to deal with 3 stocks from Lonnie. And, you know, it would be a lot harder to survive with 2.
Mm-hmm.
That being said, Bowser Jr. crew still at a very large advantage here.
All right, here we go. Charizard team on their last 3 stocks. Final player. It's all for the money, and it's not looking good immediately. Decided to go for Battlefield, which is not a bad choice.
Oh, yeah. I really like Lonnie's use of platforms here, actually. Like, he's playing it so smart.
Projectile characters really do like that,
yeah.
having the extra projectiles. But at the same time, if you have the mobility to escape them and use those platforms, then that's in your favor.
Oh,
Charizard doesn't have the best mobility in the game, but he still flaps. He's got a couple jumps in him.
That's true.
So he's able to survive a lot longer than the other bigger characters like Rob, well, not necessarily Rob, but Bowser, day to day, that kind of thing.
Yeah. I like how well Lonnie is like using the platforms to capitalize. Shadow's use of Flamethrower, really nice because he knows that stops the cart in its tracks like way before it can even get close to him, way before he can like jump and do any sort of mix-up. It just straight up stops it. It's free damage.
Mecha Koopa just accidentally causing Larry to get knocked out a little bit. I like the choice of Larry, though.
Yeah. We've seen Ludwig, Bowser Jr., Larry. I'm still hoping for Iggy, but I think Jaeger Bomb is the last
player. Not here, so.
Yeah, he plays regular Bowser Jr. as well, I believe, and that's already the
good
first
read
stock
to that
off
up
Shadow.
Smash. Wow. Yeah, once again, you said it before. You don't want to do that neutral getup.
Oh yeah, it's
not
so
against
scary.
Bowser Jr.
He has so many like super long lasting kill moves.
Mm-hmm. And Charizard's reach on his getup attack is actually not bad. I think he should have gone for it.
Oh yeah, he does a kick, right? It's like a super long kick. Oh, I like that setup into Rock Smash.
It was a good choice. It was a safe choice.
Very subtly,
sure.
Yeah.
But he needs to play this game a lot less, or a lot more, like the opponent has 5 stocks and not 2.
Yeah.
But he needs to keep that in mind.
Yeah, that's very true. You know, maybe like playing, you know, kind of safe, going hit for hit. You know, he's not.
Right there, we just saw it. The Mecha Koopa does in fact explode in your hand.
Yep. That back air is gonna take it out.
2016. I want to say this all day. There are so many back air kills in this game.
There are so many very nice back airs.
There are so few characters that have bad back airs. Like we got what, Little Mac, Greninja. Who else has a bad back air?
I don't think Greninja's back air is. I don't even think it's bad. It's just like not.
Like
particularly
his weakest in
move.
His arsenal. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's still like a solid move. I don't know, other than Mac, like you said, I can't really think of anyone without a bad
Falco,
back
maybe?
Air. No, Falco's backer kills at like 60, dude.
Oh, well then.
Oh my gosh!
There it is!
That's the Shadow special, dude. He'll throw you, he'll do like, instead of doing like, sometimes he does down throw, but he'll throw you into forward air all game, And then he'll start doing it like when it's not necessarily like, guaranteed anymore. Like,
man,
he'll
Shadows.
Do like down throw forward air, and you know, you're like, oh well, that's not the percent it can hit. I can just mash air dodge and get out of it. And then you mash air dodge and he does that to you.
Shadow's ahead of the game, man.
Yeah.
2017 Super Smash Brothers. Nice down air. I'm sorry, 2017 is up air. Man, he's 2 years ahead of the game. Crazy. Who are you getting rid of here? What are we watching here?
I think this is the spike.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, down tilt, gets him to the ledge, rolls behind the
That was
F
a dangerous
smash.
Roll there. Can we talk about that for a minute?
Yeah, because if he had gotten clipped by the back hit of it, that could have been very rough. But it did pay huge dividends for him, so it was worth it. He kept that second stock. That's so, so important because, you know, winning this 2 stocks to 3 is so much more doable than winning this 1 stock to 3.
Right.
You know?
All right, so we got ourselves both heavy hitters, Jaegerbomb versus Shadow. Both understand the character. But who's going to come out on top? Let's go.
Oh, that's right. Jaegerbomb plays Lemmy. Not regular Bowser Jr. I remember that now. I don't know why I thought he played regular Bowser Jr.
That's right. He kind of looks like regular Bowser Jr. except with crazier hair and crazier eyeballs.
A little bit. Right now, Jaegerbomb definitely like securing the lead. This is what we've been seeing for pretty much every match, right? Is like Bowser Jr. instantly takes like a 50-60% lead, no problem. Zard really seems to have like issues getting in on Bowser Jr. It's just like Bowser Jr. needs to be able to take that stock as fast as he can, because if he can't, Zard can bring it back and
there's the hammer combo.
Yeah.
But as typical in this matchup, Charizard being a heavy character, he'll survive a little longer.
Yeah, that would have killed like 95% of the cast.
There's
and that one
another
should
one.
Do it. Woo! Jaegerbomb not at all phased by his kill confirmed. You know, not actually taking the stock. He just said, that's fine, I'll just get another one.
Shadow was doing a good job of being safe, but he wasn't applying any pressure at all, which is a huge like problem that a lot of heavies run into when they try to play passive against projectiles.
Yeah.
You have to apply some kind of pressure, otherwise they're going to die. Like, okay, fine, you don't have a good neutral game. That's understandable. But you have to bring something to the table.
That's
you
true.
You can't, I mean, those who don't try never look foolish, but I mean, you're still going to die. So.
Yeah, and
Oh, nice down air.
Yeah, Shadow is like.
Was that a thing?
I mean, he air dodged. So, even if it's not a thing, Shadow saw it and he capitalized. And I think, like you said, like Shadow is playing more aggressive now. Just because. Oh no!
Yep.
I don't know if he only had one jump there or what, but I feel like he could have stalled a little bit more, snapped to the ledge safely.
Well, as we saw in the other stock, where he was able to do that forward smash and catch him before he